Greetings everyone, we will continue our discussion on object-oriented programming through C++. In the previous session, we have started about inheritance and we told you about what is inheritance and what are the various types of inheritance we have and how to implement those inheritances. Okay, in this session, we will be looking about what are the advantages and disadvantages regarding the inheritance, and we will be looking at two different topics called as virtual base classes and virtual functions. Okay. So, in the previous session, we have looked about what is inheritance, and I told you about five different types of inheritance, that is your simple inheritance as single inheritance, multiple inheritance, hierarchical inheritance, hybrid inheritance and multi-level inheritance. Okay, among these inheritance and how to use them, I told you in the previous session. So, what is the advantage of using the inheritance and what are the disadvantages of having inheritance in your programs? So first we will be looking at the advantages. So the first and foremost advantage the inheritance provides is your reusability. I think you remember your inheritance is about having your existing classes and you are trying to create a new class B which will use the properties of the existing class. So you are not rewriting everything here, so we are just using the already existing class which you have in your either in your libraries or in your program. So this particular class is already present, that class may be defining its own data variables, it might be defining its own member functions and other functionalities. What you are doing is you are creating new class and you are trying to reuse this existing class. Okay. So, whatever the simple programs you might write, you might be writing both the programs. That is, you might be writing both the classes. But the actual inheritance involves that this particular class is already existing in your system and you are trying to reuse this particular thing. Okay. You are just trying to reuse your existing class in your program. So, at that time, this particular functionality provides reusability. You will not be rewriting each and everything of your existing code. So when a class inherits or derives another class, it can access all the functionality of the inherited class. Okay, when your B is inheriting CA, okay, it will inherit all the particular properties and functionalities of A. Okay, so that is why we will be calling it as code reusability. So the code reusability will be provided by your inheritance concept. Next, the reusability enhances reliability. Okay, what is reliability? The base class code will be already tested and debugged. Okay, whatever the code that is written in this one, okay, this code will be already tested and it will be debugged and no errors will be present in that particular code. So, you need not recheck each and everything whenever you are creating the inheritance part. So, this thing is already present. So, whatever the system which you are created, that is the new system which you have created from the already existing class will be more reliable compared to what you write from fresh. That is, you rewrite the A, you rewrite the B, each and everything. If you rewrite, there is a chance of getting errors into the code. So, when you reuse the code, your code will be more robust and you can be having less number of errors in your code. And as the existing code is reused, it leads to less development and maintenance cost. Okay. So, the less development and maintenance cost involves that, okay, you need not rewrite this code and you need not develop the complete part whatever that is present here. So, this might be somewhat simple when you look at small programs, but when you look at large programs where large number of lines of code are involved, at that time this inheritance concept will provide lots of development and maintenance cost. You need not develop this complete code, you need not maintain the code of a particular already existing class. Okay, this will provide the advantage over rewriting the code each and every time. Okay, so the main thing you have to understand while implementing your inheritance is the reusability part. So whenever you implement the inheritance, it will provide the reusability. That is the most important advantage you will be getting while implementing the inheritance. Okay. And other advantages you have as a part of inheritance is, inheritance makes the subclasses follow a standard interface. What is the meaning of this is, when you perform inheritance, there is an already existing class and you will be having a set of functions which will be implemented in that particular class. Okay, the class A will be already existing class, that will be your super class or your base class. So the base class will be having the already existing functionality. So whatever the subclasses that you implement, that means if you implement B or C, okay, they have to follow a standard interface. That is, the inheritance makes the subclasses follow a standard interface. So whatever that particular subclass, that is B or C, which is trying to rewrite the code or which is trying to implement the already existing functions, like those functions might be present in A. So if the subclasses wants to implement the functions which is present in A, okay, they have to follow a standard interface. That is, they will not be rewriting each and every. Okay, so they will be following interfaces. That is, if you are writing the code for B, so it might be having its own functions. That is, it might be having functions D, E, F. C might be having some its own function G. Okay, whenever you write the code for any class or subclasses, you will be following some set of predefined, what you will be calling it as, like an interface. That is, if I write this code, you should be thinking that in future, this particular class might be used by, or it might be inherited by another class. So it will be following some certain standards so that it might be inherited in the future. So this is why inheritance is very much important for code reusability, and it will act like an interface. Why? Because in the future you might reuse this code as well. Okay. Inheritance help to reduce the code redundancy. That is, code redundancy means you will not be rewriting the already existing code. Okay, you might be writing some code here, you will not be rewriting the code, same code in another application. So we will be reducing the code redundancy, and supports code extensibility. What is extensibility? Whatever the code you have written here, you might extend the particular code. For example, initially you might be writing code for a simple calculator. Okay, this might be having a set of functions like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Okay, you will be writing a code for your simple calculator with a class and a set of functions. In future, if you want to write another code which will implement scientific calculator, you need not rewrite each and everything. That is, you need not rewrite addition, subtraction, multiplication code. Whatever that is present, that is, whatever you want to implement in the scientific calculator, you might be implementing here, and you might be extending the already existing code. So there is already a code and you are trying to extend the particular functionality. So your inheritance provides this code extensibility, and it will reduce your code redundancy. That is, you will not be rewriting the same code again and again. You will try to extend the already existing code. So last one, inheritance facilitates creation of class libraries. Okay, this is another important thing you have to understand about your inheritance. As you can understand, you will be writing your class libraries at the initial part. Okay, like hash include iostream, hash include conio. So all those things will be calling them as libraries. So these libraries contain your already existing functionalities of your language. So whenever you write these functionalities, you will mostly be extending the particular code. In the future also, even if you are extending your language, you try to add some more functionality to the language. At that time, you need not write each and everything. You just need to extend the already existing libraries. So if you want to add something, that is, if I want to extend a new functionality to the already existing language, you need not write the code again and again. Okay, whatever the libraries which are present, you can extend those libraries. And you can group a set of functionalities into the library. So your inheritance provides this library support. Okay, so I think you can understand the main importance of having your inheritance in your language is the code reusability. So the code reusability will provide all the existing advantages what you are seeing here. So the main important thing is reusability. That reusability will provide all these advantages. That is, it will provide the code reliability. Why? Because you need not write the code again and again. It will be reused, the code will be reused, so you will not be getting large number of errors. So that is why you will be having less development cost and maintenance cost. That is why, because the code is already present, you will be writing the extension parts only. So you will be having less development cost and maintenance cost. And whatever that makes, it will be acting like an interface. One classes will be acting like an interfaces to the further classes. And your inheritance will support your code reusability. That is why it will reduce the code redundancy. Okay, you will not be rewriting the codes. And it will support the code extensibility. Okay, you will be extending the already present codes. And it will provide the library creations. Okay. So the main thing you have to understand is reusability. The reusability will provide all these advantages which are part of your inheritance. Then what is the disadvantages of having inheritance in your C++? So the disadvantages is inheritance function works slower than normal functions as there is indirection. Okay, whatever the functions which are present as a part of inheritance, those functions will work slower compared to normal functions. What does this mean? For example, if you are having a class A, class A is having a function like funFun. Okay, class A is having a function like funFun, and you are trying to inherit the same function into class B. That is, if I want to inherit B, that is, if I want to inherit function into B, I have to use the inheritance. Now I can create the objects bb1 and I can call b1.fun. So this is how you will be implementing your inheritance and call the already existing function in A. Okay, and you can rewrite the code. That is, you can have your own separate class B and you can have your own function fun. That is, you can have a class B and you can have fun. So if I try to implement this particular function, that is, if I try to call create v1.fu, so this is a direct method for your particular class B, and this, that is, function is not direct method for B, it is an inherited method for B. So there is some indirection, that is, indirectly I am trying to call the function in this particular inheritance part. So when I compare these two, this will be faster. That is, the direct method call will be faster compared to an indirect method call. Okay. So when you are implementing your inheritance, so the inherited function, that is, this is the inherited function, that is fun, this is the inherited function, will work slower than the normal function. So in this case, this is the normal function where you are having the class and it is having its own function. Okay. So the normal functions will execute faster compared to the inherited function. Why? Because I have a indirection. That is, first I have to go to B, then I have to go to A. Okay, why I have to go to B, I will tell in the next part. For the time being, know that there will be an indirection part. Okay, so the improper use of inheritance may lead to wrong solutions. Okay, what is the meaning of this? So when you try to implement the inheritance, you have to have more consciousness, that is, what you are writing and where you are writing the code. For example, if I write a function fun here, if I am having the class A and if I am having a fun function, so this is part of A and there is a class B, the class B is inheriting class A, and if I have another function with the same name, that is, if I have another function with the same name, so this thing will be calling it as function overriding. So remember, this concept is not specified in your syllabus, but you have to understand this. So there is a class, there is a function in class A, that is your parent class or your base class, and there is a function in class B with the same name as your particular function in your class A. Okay, at that time, if I call B1, so if I create the object B1 and if I call fun, So at this instance, it will execute this function. It will not execute the parent base class function. So this is called as function overriding, where you are already having a function and you don't want to use that particular functionality and you are overriding that particular thing. For example, this particular function might do some functionality and you are not interested in that functionality and you want to have your own functionality. So at that time, I can rewrite the thing in class B. There might be other functions which the class B might be interested, which are present in A. Okay, but it is not interested in fun, so it will be implementing its own functionality. So at that time, that is writing the same function but with a different functionality in your derived class or child class, will be calling it as function overriding. We are overriding the function. Remember, there is a difference between function overloading and function override. Function overloading means you will be writing the same function, that is function with same name inside the same class but with different parameters. That is one, this will be one function and this will be another function. So that is function overloading. So there is a difference between function overloading and function overriding. In function overriding, you are having the same function but one function is present in the base class, another function is present in the child class, and this particular child class function will override the already existing class A function. Okay, so why you are overriding means the particular derived class or the child class is not interested in the functionality of this particular function, so it is overriding and it is writing its own functionality. So this thing will be calling it as function override. So why I am specifying this thing is, so without proper use, that is if you are not properly using this thing, okay, and you might make a mistake. In certain situations, if improper use of your inheritance will provide wrong results. Okay, if I don't have this thing, this particular function will call this one. If I have this one, this particular object will call this function. Okay, if you are not aware of these things and if you use properly, okay, if you are not using properly, then your inheritance might give wrong results. So proper use of your inheritance will give you some advantages of code reuse, but improper use of your inheritance will give you wrong results. So while inheriting, you have to have proper idea about what are the functions you are inheriting, what are the classes you are inheriting, and what are the functions present in your parent class, and what are the functions present in your base class, whether there is a function overriding. Okay, so which particular function to call from your objects, which not to call, what is the object you are trying, what is the overloading, what is the inheritance you are doing, whether you are doing a public inheritance, private inheritance, protected inheritance. Based upon all these issues, you have to remember what is happening in your program. So if you are not using properly, then you will be getting wrong solutions or wrong results. And other disadvantages as a part of this particular inheritance is, so data members in the base class are left unused, which may lead to memory wastage. Another disadvantage of your inheritance is, if I am having class A and if I create some variables A, B, C, and again I am creating class B, and inside the class B I use only the B variable and I am not using A and C at all. Okay, this A and C is not used in either A or B, and if I declare them as protected variables, at that time you can see there are lots of members in base class which are left unused in class B. That is, this class B will get the copy of all the items that are present in class A. At that time, you will be wasting a lots of space in your program. Next, the inheritance increases the coupling between base class and derived class. A change in base class will affect all the child classes. So I think you can understand, once if you are inheriting, that is once class B is inheriting the properties of class A, there is a strong coupling between class A and class B. Okay, at that instance, if you are changing B, there will be no effect to class A. But if you are changing A, if there is some change in A, whatever may be the classes that are inheriting class A, they will be affected directly. Okay, if there is a change in class A, all the class which is deriving the class A will be affecting directly. So, you have to be understanding what is the change you are doing. If the change is directly affecting class B or C or whatever the derived classes which are present. So, you have to be keeping in mind what you are doing while changing your base classes. Okay, so these are the disadvantages you have in while performing inheritance in C++ or any other language. So, the main disadvantage is you will be having a slower functions compared to general functions, and if you are not using properly, you will be getting wrong solutions, and the base class members, if they are not utilized in your derived classes, lots of memory will be wasted, and there is a strong coupling between base classes and derived classes, and if there is a change in your base class, those affect directly your derived classes. So, this is about your advantages and disadvantages of your inheritance. I think you can understand. So, the main advantage is your reusability. If you want to have reusability in your program, that is, if you are writing a code which you think might be reused in the future, at that time you have to implement your inheritance. Okay. Or, more specifically, you can understand, when you are writing some application, you have to search for whether there is an already existing class present out there. If there is an already existing class, whether I can reuse the class or not. If I can reuse that particular class, I will implement my inheritance. Otherwise, I can go for a fresh class. Okay. So, that is how you have to implement your inheritance. But if you are thinking about all these disadvantages, it is better to avoid inheritance. Okay. That is about your inheritance. Next, we will be looking at other topics closely related to your inheritance, and we'll be looking at what are virtual base classes. Next, we'll be looking at virtual functions. After that, we'll be looking at abstract functions, abstract classes. All those things we'll be looking. So, all these topics are closely related to inheritance and how this inheritance will imply upon them. So, first thing is, what are virtual base classes? So, virtual base classes are used in virtual inheritance in a way of preventing multiple instances of a given class appearing in inheritance hierarchy when you are using multiple inheritances. You might not be understanding this all this particular thing. So, I will go to the example, then I will come back to this particular thing. For example, if you are having this particular type of inheritance, what you are trying to implement here. So, I told you various types of inheritance, we will be having multiple inheritance, multi-level inheritance and single inheritance, all those things. So, this is one type of your multiple inheritance. Okay. So, at this time you can see class A is providing, that is class A is your base class, and the class B and class C is taking the properties of your class C. So, if you are having a variable A, that is variable A is present in class A. So, class A will provide a it will provide A to class B, and it will provide A to class C. So, there will be a value present in class B, and there will be a value present in class C. Okay. So, it will be class A's A, and it will also be class B's A. It will be class A's A, and it will be also class C's A. At this time, if you implement this inheritance, that is, this is the multiple inheritance where class D is inheriting properties from class B and class C. At this time, D has now two A's. One is from B and another is from A. Okay, we are having two A's, one is inherited from B and another is inherited from C. So, at this time, which one you have to implement? Whether you have to use class B's A or whether you have to use class C's A. This ambiguity will be avoided, this ambiguity will occur at class D. So, to avoid this situation, that is where you are implementing your multiple inheritance, okay, at that time you will be having this problem. So, to implement or to avoid this ambiguity for class D, okay, you are going for your virtual base classes. Virtual base classes are used in virtual inheritance in a way preventing multiple instances. What are the multiple instances? So these multiple instances mean your A here, okay, your class D, whatever the class D that is having, it is having multiple instances of A. There is a BCA and there is a CCA, okay. You are having multiple instances, that is same A value is coming from class B as well as class C. So it is appearing here. So multiple instances of a given class are appearing in inheritance hierarchy when using multiple inheritances. So when I am using multiple inheritance, there is multiple instances which are coming into class A. Okay. So to avoid this part, we will be using your virtual base classes. Where you are having ambiguity like this, you are going to implement your virtual base classes. So in the next session, we will be looking about this particular, how to implement this virtual base classes and how it will avoid your ambiguity. And we will be looking at other topics in the next session. Thank you.